does market makers need to hedge? Quick answer will be no, they don't have to. But the long answer will be that it is a good idea a lot of times for market makers to create a hedge, right? So remember that what kind of risk market makers face, right? So the main one, the one that have the most impact on the market maker activity is the inventory risk. We have a great article explaining a bit more in details what is inventory risk and how it works and what's on the line for the market makers taking this risk. But on a short resume, the goal for the market maker is to capture the spread, right? The goal isn't to profit from market direction, right? The market maker, the plan isn't to enter a market, wait for the price to go up and sell the asset and take the profit. That's not the plan. The plan for the market maker is to execute a buy and a sell at a certain difference at the spread, and that difference between the buy and sell that he executes, it's going to be his profit. So what the market maker wants is to execute a lot of trades, capturing small profit margins over the time, right? So that means that to do that, a market maker needs to have an inventory, right? So if I want to market making BTC versus USD, that means that I need to have BTC, Bitcoin, to create the sell orders, right? Or else I'm not market making, I'm just buying and selling later. I need to have this inventory to create this twin positions to capture the spread. That's the whole plan of the market making. This is where the inventory risk comes in, right? If I need the inventory, that means that I am exposed to whatever is the price movement of that asset, okay? So if I have BTC, an inventory of BTC, the amount of spreads I capture as market maker could not be enough to cover moments where the price goes downtrend starts. Because that means that, okay, I'm capturing the spreads, my strategy is working, I'm doing a lot of opposing trades, great. But my inventory have a value. If the price go down, whole value of my process also go down, right? So this is where hedge comes in. Because if the market maker acquire the inventory and execute a hedge, at the same moment, the price direction doesn't matter anymore, right? Because as we've seen previously, the profit is locked. Doesn't matter what's the direction, there won't be any plus or any gain or loss from that inventory. So that's the whole point of our market makers to create the hedge. And an important thing to notice is that the inventory risk gets even worse when you look at what we call exotic pairs, right? From pairs that are the base currency is a totally different currency that when your reference is, let's say, USD, right? So the example I have here is on the market Avalanche and Binance, in Binance coin. At first look, a market like this is great for market makers, right? So it's ranging, there isn't big moves on the market for crypto, of course, because -3% in the day is really big in some markets. But in a general looks that, yeah, the situation is pretty good for market makers. So he started the day at this price, acquired the inventory, executed the trade, a lot of spreads captured, price went down a bit, but okay, it came back to the same level of price that he acquired the inventory. So all good, all fine. But let's take a look at the price of both assets on versus USDT. Right, both prices at the same time frame. What happened with both of them is that they dropped in value, right? So your market making activity captured the spread between Avalanche and Binance coin. You did get profits, your the amount of relative coins related to Avalanche and Binance Coin went up. But when you look at the other base currency like USD, what happened is that both assets lost value. So how much profitable market maker operation you had to do to cover this 20% loss on both assets, right? So that's it gets even more important when you look to market maker. The point is, in a general sense, market makers want their inventory value change to be equal to zero, right? Because again, the objective of a market maker isn't to profit from price movements, it's to profit from capturing spreads from the market. I can argue here that if market maker have an inventory and the price goes up, he gains both the spread he's capturing and the price increase the value of his inventory, right? So he win both ways. So in a basic sense, the whole idea is to have chain zero, but you can also, as a market maker, to make some calls, some decisions that, let's say, your expectation is that an uptrend starts, so maybe you don't need the hedge, since you're going to also get profits from the price increase of your inventory, right? So it's more about decision that the market maker must do. So it's a situation where not necessarily every time, 24 hours a day, the inventory needs to be hedged, right? So there's opportunities where the price can go up and you can also get some return on your investment, on your operations, gaining from the price. So it's more about understanding when to hedge, if it's worth to hedge, if there is risk on the market of your inventory losing value, and a lot of different features that each market maker need to take some time to think how, why, and when it's going to do the hedge. How to hedge as a market maker? So we do have a classic professional type of hedge that market makers use. It's called the delta hedge. I'm not going to be covering this here because it's a bit complex, because it's involved more than the price, involved the usually this is done with option markets. It's involved the price of the option, the premium, and a lot of other features. But a more direct way for market makers to do is just do a direct opposing execution, right? So on the example here, we have, let's say, as a market maker, I have this buy and the sell order. And what happened is that the price goes down a bit. And what I could do is that I can, at the moment that my buy order is taken, I can immediately execute a short position on the perpetual market, right? So buy happens on my spot where I am making the market. The moment this happens, I execute an opposite. So I lock the inventory value and I am protected to whatever is the direction, both up and down. But as always, remember, there are risks. On this case, for the market maker, we can highlight that type of operation to hedge, directly executing and at the same moment, a spot where market making is taken, there is the risk of the price that the hedge is executed is worse, and I start the hedge losing some value. The hedge is not executing in time, so the execution risk. As I mentioned, back the liquidations, you have to be sure you do have enough margin on the hedge account, on the futures account to cover whatever fast movements can happen in the market, or else there's the risk of liquidation and the negative funding rates that we already mentioned. It's important to consider there is the cost to do the hedge. You get the protection, you won't suffer from price movements, but there is a cost associated with that. Every time you execute a trade, you pay an extra fee. Every time you miss the right price to execute the hedge, you add an extra loss to the position. So all things, if you're going, if you're planning to start to hedge your market making position, make sure to consider what's the cost of, if it's worth it, right? Like every kind of trade, nothing is 100% risk-free. So even though the purpose of hedging is to reduce the risk, there is still some risk that you need to consider when you are going to create this hedge. Make this happen. Okay, so one of the most prominent ones will be the liquidation risks, right? So in this case, we had an event in the past that the spike on the perpetual contract went way faster than spot market. And these spikes usually happen; they go up really fast and then they go down to the previous level price really fast. Since every derivative, it works on margin. You need to have margin deposited to have a position there. That means that if that margin that you're using goes below a certain value, the exchange or the protocol automatically liquidate your position, right? So it closes your position without your wanting to do it, right? So this is one risk that you need to consider, is that on these events that happens sometimes, it happens a lot on crypto. From my perspective, that it started to not happen as much as used to be, but still happens a lot, is that on this situation, let's say if I open a short position here and I didn't have enough margin on the account, this movement definitely would liquidate the account, right? So what would happen is that I take the loss on the perpetual market. The loss fixed because the position is liquidated. You don't have any more positions there. But I still have the spot position. So the whole difference is gone and all the protection is gone. So there's something really important that you need to consider when you're looking to make hedge, especially with cryptocurrency. Another risk, as I mentioned, you can build the position to receive an interest in funds, but there are times where the interest in payment is inverted. So as you can see here, there are two moments on time that on last year and the middle of this year, most of the time, the interest in funds rate were negative. Right? So that means that if you open a short position, instead of receiving the interest rate, you would be paying the interest rate, right? So there's also another risk to consider, because as you can see, most of the time, the interest rate is positive, paying for shorts, but there are times that the opposite could happen. So you have to also keep an eye on it, because if the interest rates is negative for a very long time and you have a short position, that means that your margin is going to be reduced over time, and then you also increase the risk of liquidation. Okay, so that's another risk always to also to keep an eye on. Okay, so a few other risks that are important is that you, when you consider derivatives that have deliverable option, let's say for option markets or normal futures that have a deliverable date, it's not about if you win or lose money, but if the execution date happens, you might be obligated to deliver whatever you cover with your position, right? So if you don't want to make this delivery, if you want to keep the asset no matter what, you have always to keep an eye for what are going to be the execution dates on this type of contract. On crypto, the exchange counterparty risk. So it is an unregulated market. So make sure you know how good and how reliable the exchange or the protocol you are executing the hedge is, right? And the trade execution risk. So as any other trade, what happened is that you have the risk execute the trade, the hedge position at a not so good price, right? So you could create a negative gap. For example, You could buy at 10K, and when you try to open the short position, you can only execute it at a 9K. So that means there is a gap of 1K. You start the hedge already losing minus one because the difference is negative. So it's something the way that the trade is executed is always something that you need to do the as best as possible. Also, the hedge order is not being executed in time. So you could make a market order on the futures, or you could create a limit order. And let's suppose there is a high volume on the market and the price is moving fast. You try to create the order at the price you want to make sure you don't have a negative gap on your structure. And what happens is that the market moves faster than you are able to create the orders. So you don't execute the order, your order just becomes a limit order that's not filled. So the price keeps moving and you miss it, the cover. One other way, and really important for Hummingbot users, is related to doing a proper hedge. It's a great way to capture, how to say, periphery, sideways opportunities, right? So we have the liquidity mining program, right? And you can start, if you are only interested in taking the rewards for liquidity mining, you're not really interested in keeping that asset for a very long time, you just want to participate in liquidity mining. So the usual approach to reduce this risk and only take the liquidity mining is that you try to make your spread higher, bigger spreads, to try to avoid the execution of your orders, right? Because the plan is not to have to create an inventory of the asset, it's to just capture the liquidity mining. So a good way is that, so instead of that, of increasing the spread, what means that the bigger the spread, the less reward you get from liquidity mining. Instead of doing that, what you could do is to hedge all the positions you're doing on the liquidity mining, right? So that means that market direction is eliminated, considering the cost, of course. And what happens now is that you can set a way smaller spread to capture these liquidity mining, because you won't lose due to price movements. You are only capturing the spreads plus the liquidity mining reward. And this is also true when you look at all the other possibilities of reward that we see flowing around from time to time in crypto, like other rewards. The one that I can highlight right now will be the dYdX token distribution. You are hedging your position, you are liquidity mining, and you're doing your hedge on dYdX. Zero risk, basically, a small risk. Let's say, let's add the cost, let's consider the cost, let's consider the liquidation and the interest rate. No price movement exposure. You are receiving the liquidity mining rewards and you are receiving the dYdX tokens. Right, so there is a lot of opportunities. So the trick here, especially if you are a small market maker, you don't have a lot of funds, you don't have a big structure to run to participate in this liquidity campaigns and other reward distribution, is to exactly make a good plan to hedge your position. You're taking the rewards and from these campaigns. I see, not only I mentioned dYdX, but if you look around, you always see a lot of trading competitions, for example, right? So you can enter the trading competitions without necessarily being exposed to the price movement. So there is a huge range of opportunities that can be found around everywhere on the cryptocurrency market. So take a look at this, look around for this, and plan ahead how it's going to do both times, right? To execute the market making with a hedge and not being exposed to the price movement.